There's been a lot of hubbub going on online since Shane Dawson has been putting kids on blast on Twitter for saying pretty mean things about his series, Inside the Mind of Jake Paul. So in this video, we're gonna talk about how to raise your kids not to be a jerk, how to be a more effective parent when they're getting marketed to, and I also brought a special guest with me. What is up, everybody? This is Chris from The Rewired Soul, where we talk about the problem, but focus on the solution. And if you're new to my channel's all about mental health. So what I like to do is take things going on in the YouTube community or pop culture and try to teach you how to improve your mental health. So in case you didn't notice, I have a special guest with me. Go ahead and introduce yourself to the audience.
I am Chris's son, Dylan, and I have a YouTube channel.
He just called me Chris. So yeah, Dylan has a YouTube channel, and I'm gonna link it down in the description below, so make sure you go check it out. We need to do more videos over there. But yeah, anyways, I brought Dylan along because I had a lot of people asking me my thoughts about Shane retweeting teenagers and putting them on blast, and I'm like, I don't really wanna talk about that because I probably have some unpopular opinions, but you know what? I haven't had my son on my channel for a while, and like, I know that parenting is different for everybody, and we all have our own styles and things like that, so I'm just gonna share with you how I parent, why I parent, and Dylan and I are gonna share some of our experiences. So basically, Dylan is not caught up to date on the Shane Dawson series, but Dylan, what do you know about Shane Dawson? Like, you used to watch Shane Dawson, right? What kind of videos were you watching?
I was watching like his dye videos. Not like, it's DIY, not D-I-E. Yeah, and I would like also watch like some, like, I would watch like a lot of his like just weird videos.
Yeah.
Yeah, I wouldn't like his, I don't really like his theory videos.
The
like
conspiracy theory ones? He hasn't done one of those in a while. Shane, you haven't done a conspiracy theory video in a while. But anyways, yeah, so Dylan, like me and Dylan actually used to watch a lot of Shane Dawson because he would just watch the goofy stuff. But anyways, I haven't told Dylan all of the story yet, but I just wanna, I'm gonna share with Dylan what's been happening on Twitter and just kind of get Dylan's thoughts on it. So one of the first things that happened was a young woman, 16 years old, and wait, how old are you, Dylan? Tell everybody.
I am 9, almost 10.
Almost 10. He's a New Year's Eve baby. He'll be 10 on New Year's Eve. So a young woman, 16 years old, she tweeted something at Shane, and Shane retweeted what she said. And here's the thing, I don't know if I'll be able to put it up on the screen, but I'll try. But this one I'm not gonna ask you about, Dylan. Like, for me, it was just the way it was phrased, and I think a lot of us, if we looked at that, we would have gotten defensive too. Let me just ask you for argument's sake, Dylan. Like, You don't talk to people online. Like, well, you talk to people like in Fortnite, right?
Yeah.
But do you know what an exclamation point is?
Yeah. It's a line, and at the bottom, it's like an upside down I.
Yeah, upside down I, right? Like, if somebody writes you something and put exclamation points, what do you think that means? Like, how do you interpret that?
What do you mean by interpret?
Like if I sent you a message that said hi, period, and then if I sent you a message that said hi, exclamation point, how would you see the difference between those two? What would you think?
Maybe,
if somebody was saying it.
Maybe the person was mad, maybe the person was mad, maybe excited. Like, more, like, not just hi, it's like hi or hi.
Right, so basically, okay, so I have a 9-year-old son here, and he, like, by the way, we didn't, like, you know, script this or anything, but what I wanted to point out is that my 9-year-old son understands that exclamation points can be interpreted as yelling, sometimes excitement, but with the first tweet that Shane retweeted, the young woman was sending him like these things with exclamation points, but then she went on Reddit and was like playing the victim and saying, I was just trying to provide him with constructive criticism. But this is important that we talk about, like, the things we say and how we say them is how people interpret things. I've been talking on my channel a lot about perspective, right? And like, there's a lot that gets lost in translation online, so like, we gotta be mindful of how we say things. So, the other tweet that Shane just got some backlash on, so basically, there's this tweet right here. A young woman said, Shane Dawson, stop giving racists a platform. And Shane Dawson said this. But anyways, what happened was, this young woman ended up retweeting it and saying, Shane literally is liking tweets saying I deserve all the hate I'm getting for respectfully calling him out. I'm literally so disgusted right now, I'm seriously livid. So a lot of you saw my video the other day about Alyssa Violet, and like, I'm just a huge advocate of empowerment and not playing the victim and taking responsibility for this. So Dylan, if you like publicly sent something out on Twitter to a big YouTuber and you were saying something that could be mean, and that YouTuber then did something mean to you, like, what are your thoughts about that?
I would think that if I did that, I think I would kind of deserve it, because if you did something mean to a YouTuber, you shouldn't expect happy thoughts from that YouTuber.
Right? And he's 9 years old. So we have like these teenagers saying, oh my God, I can't believe Shane Dawson did this. But like, this is why we teach our kids not to do that stuff. Like, I'm telling you right now, like I was telling my girlfriend about this, like if Dylan did that and Dylan came crying to me saying, oh my God, Shane Dawson's being mean to me,
that'd be dumb.
Yeah, the first thing I say to him is like, well, what did you do? You know, this actually comes up in Fortnite sometimes, you know, Dylan plays a lot of Fortnite with kids online, and when he tells me like somebody did something mean to him in the game or something, I always ask him, I'm like, did you do anything? Like, just so we can help get to the bottom of it. I don't want Dylan to grow up thinking that the whole world's out to get him and he's just not doing anything wrong. How is he ever gonna grow or learn or expand from these things? So the next thing that we'll talk about is, we've been talking about Jake Paul marketing to children and things like that. So Dylan, what do you spend most of your money on?
V-Bucks and Fortnite.
Yeah, a lot of money on V-Bucks and Fortnite. So I totally agree with like Nerd City's video and everything, but at the end of the day too, at the end of the day, I think a lot of this comes down to us as the parents. So Dylan, do I give you all of the V-Bucks that you want?
No, but if I earn my money and I save up and I'm only a few dollars away, then maybe you can pitch in and give me a few more bucks.
Yeah, yeah. So sometimes, like, if he's close, but he has to earn it. So, like, that's the thing. Like, just to give you a little neuroscience real quick, kids, before they hit kind of like the pubescent age, like 12, 13 years old, they get extreme bursts of dopamine, okay? They get really excited really easily. So that's something that happens with kids when they get marketed to. So Dylan sees new skins in Fortnite and he gets really, really excited. He will call me from his mom's house and call me and da 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 and all that. It's our job as parents to bring them back down. It's our job as parents to teach them responsibility, to teach them patience. Like, we can't put everything on these YouTubers, which then transitions us into the next subject. So here's what's funny, and right before we recorded this video, I was like, oh my God, I can't wait to talk about this. So a lot of people who, you know, see how I take things from the YouTube community to try to teach you about mental health, I do the same thing with Dylan, because the main thing is, we need to take everything we're consuming, we need to take it as a learning experience. So, like, I don't care what Dylan watches on YouTube most of the time, but if it's something that might make him make some bad decisions or lead him to make some bad decisions, you know what we do? We talk about it. So Dylan went through a phase where he was watching like list videos and stuff.
Yeah.
So there was like a top 10 ways to cheat on a test. What were some of the ways that you could cheat on a test?
Like, I don't really remember them, but like one, I'm in the thumbnail, I'm pretty sure it was like someone wrote like the answer on their tooth or something, or like in the inside of their glasses, and it doesn't really make sense, because if you cheat on a test, I mean you get a good grade and maybe you get some ice cream, but it's not gonna affect if you're smarter.
Yeah, and like, that's the thing, like, I didn't care that Dylan was watching that. Like, when Dylan was watching that, that triggered something in my brain. I'm like, oh no, is this video teaching my son how to cheat? We better have a conversation about it. And that's one of the issues, is that there's a lot of parents out there who just sit their kid in front of YouTube or TV and say, okay, good luck, and then they wanna get mad at the TV or the YouTubers for what they're doing. And it's like, no, it's our responsibility as parents. Like, you have people like Jake Paul, Logan Paul, Tana Mojo, and all these other things, but like, what are we doing? Are we saying, okay, it's cool that you like this for entertainment, but let's talk about real life stuff real quick. So the last thing that we'll talk about, Dylan introduced me to a new YouTuber this morning. What channel, what's the name of this channel?
Twine Cheeks.
Twine Cheeks, so I'll link it down in the description below.
It's so funny.
Yeah, so basically there's kids right now in Fortnite who are trying to like steal in-game items from other people in the guise of a trade, okay? Like, oh, I'll trade you, but then they try to take off. So there's this YouTuber, Twine Cheeks, who's going out there and he's tricking these kids and teaching them a lesson.
Wait, yeah. I know you! Wait, yeah, no,
you're
no,
going on YouTube. No, no, you're going. No, 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 no. I'm sorry. You're going on my YouTube channel. You're getting banned, and you're going on YouTube. No. Okay, listen, listen, listen.
No.
Any last words before you go on YouTube? And I'm gonna end the clip. I'm gonna send that to Epic Games and expose you.
So Dylan showed me that this morning, right? And what was that funny one? What was the funny one where because the kids try to like play it off like they weren't really trying to scam them. What did the kid say?
Okay, so this one kid basically, like, sometimes he says, oh, my controller disconnected, and the kid's like, yes, 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 and he's like, are you dumb? Like, he picks him up, like, trying to see, and one time, this kid said, he dropped the weapon, and then he's like, oh, hang on, let me look at my inventory, he's like, yes, 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 he did a bull rush, basically, you go really fast with a little shield. My finger slipped, I was eating KFC.
Scammer gets scammed, scammer gets scammed.
Scammer gets scammed? Are you dumb? I've never traded with you, what do you mean? Did your finger slip?
My finger slipped. I was eating KFC and like my finger slipped. I forgot to wash them.
So he's yeah, and somebody said like, you know, their fingers were greasy from Kool-Aid, just weird stuff. But anyways, like Dylan was watching that this morning. He was laughing, and you know what he did? I sat down with him and I'm like, what are you learning from this? Like what are you learning about this? So Dylan, what lessons did you learn from watching Twine Cheeks this morning?
If you scam people, you're gonna, if you scam him, then you're probably gonna scam yourself. If you, at least you try, but.
Because so of what?
Because, have you ever heard of karma?
Karma.
Karma.
Karma, that's right. What's karma, Dylan?
Karma, there are two types of karma, a good and bad karma. Basically, if you do something bad, you get something bad. If you do something good, you get something good.
Right? So yeah, like. This is all I'm talking about. Like, this is just conversations we need to have with kids. Turn everything into a learning experience. And I can do this for a million other subjects. I was going to do a poll over on my community tab. I might still do it. But I wanna know from all of you, and you can leave it down in the comments below, how many of you are parents out there? Like, I just don't know. I always try to figure out, like, are you parents? Should I do more videos like this? Because we try to turn everything into a learning experience, whether it's bullies at school, whether it's just like stress or homework or sports or exercise or whatever. We try to turn these into learning experiences and things like that. Like, Dylan, drop some knowledge on them real quick. What is mindfulness?
Noticing what's happening right now.
Booyah! So we talk about mindfulness and all of that. So if you would like more videos about parenting and kids and stuff, if you'd like to see this guy some more, let me know down in the comments below. And by the way, again, we will have a link in the description over to Dylan's YouTube channel. Gonna be trying to put some more content on there, plays video games. We're moving into a new place. We'll do the Lego tour, because you have a ton of Legos, right?
Yeah,
ton of Legos. But anyways, that's all we got for this video. So if you like this video, what should they do, Dylan?
Like and subscribe, and if hopefully you do subscribe, hit the notification bell so it'll say if my dad starts streaming or posts a new video. And also, if you guys would like to play Fortnite with us, my account, my username is bootkid, bootkid, all one word, no caps or anything. And my dad's username is mstzbootman.
Yeah. So yeah, if you want to play some Fortnite with us, I'll put our Epic Game accounts down below. But yeah, again, that's all we got. Thank you, Dylan, for being amazing in this video. And huge, huge, huge thank you to everybody supporting the channel over on Patreon. You helped me do this thing. You also helped put food in this beautiful boy's little mouth. So if you would like to help support the channel, support this little boy, go ahead and click or tap on that Patreon icon right there. All right, thanks so much for watching. Say bye, Dylan.
Peace out, Girl Scouts.